Hey, what's going on everyone? Mano back here for another Destiny 2 Ascendant Challenge video guide. As always, timestamps are located on screen and in the description box below. This week, we're going to be tackling the Forfeit Shrine Ascendant Challenge. What we're going to do is head to Petravenge, who is going to be in the Strand. Once we pick up the bounty from her, we're going to go ahead and head south to the Gardens of Ysila. I've already picked up the bounty from Petravenge, so I'm going to skip that part in this video, but I figure you can figure that out. We're going to go ahead and follow that path. But before you do the Ascendant Challenge, what you want to do is, if you would like to pick up the Truth Exotic Rocket Launcher, you have not added that into your inventory, this is the week to do it. You need to go do the menagerie on normal mode. We'll actually drop an item called a scrap of paper, which will then proc the rest of the truth quest. I have a complete tutorial guide, which I'm going to link to a card as well as in this video. So if you want to get the Truth Exotic Rocket Launcher, you can go ahead and get that. This week inside of Destiny is pretty much a very chill week. This was supposed to be the week on the Season of Dawn calendar that we were supposed to get Bastion, but then everything happened with the Hexagon puzzle and the Corridors of Time, and we were able to pick up Bastion early, and we got that final really baffling end to that. What could have been an amazing quest, but honestly kind of left a bad taste in my mouth. I'm going to be doing a video on that as well. If you do want to see other content, let me know down in the comments down below. Let me know if you are looking for something specific if you'd like me to do, and I'll look forward to doing that for you as well. Once you get into the Gardens of Ysila, you're going to see a couple of mountainous structures off to the left-hand side. Go to the second one. We're going to go ahead and clear out some of those enemies because some of them are irritating and they're pretty aggressive. There are some wizards in this area. And we're going to jump up to this platform right here. You will notice that there is no portal, and that is probably because we have not used a tincture of Queen's Foil, which is the consumable that makes us ascendant. If you have no idea what we're talking about there, I'm going to go ahead and put a link in the description box below, as well as in a card in the top right hand side. Here's the map location in case you were wondering where it is. And now that we are ascendant, we can see the portal. We can hop on through and take care of the Forfeit Shrine. The Forfeit Shrine is probably the easiest of all the Ascendant challenges. It essentially just is running and gunning on a large platforming map. And there's really nothing to it other than just making sure that you avoid certain enemies. There are going to be Thrall and Knights that are going to be chasing you and spawning in random locations. There's going to be Blights that are going to try and slow you down. There's going to be guys with shields that are going to try and blast you off the edge. So you basically just want to be on your toes. You want to make sure that you kill those enemies as soon as possible. The Ascendant Challenge goes like this. You grab 3 orbs that are located randomly throughout the map. Without dying to any of the enemies, including the big giant knights that I just pointed to, you need to bring those arc charges down to the middle, slam them into the middle, which will make a pool of boundless light, which you can then use to kill the 3 knights that are chasing you in this Ascendant Challenge. You'll see that I'm doing that right here. I just dropped the first orb into the middle. I recommend going for the highest orb first, just because you're fresh into the Ascendant Challenge. You don't maybe have that many enemies chasing you. It's really easy to kind of see the layout of where everything is, so you can kind of take a look at where you need to be leaping to or jumping to. You can kind to make a plan. I'm going to move over here to this area, and again, there's really no easy way for me to tell you where they are, because again, these 3 orbs will randomly generate. What I will tell you to do is, if you see some blights that there's no easy way to get around, or you're worried you're going to get hit off the edge, or they're really close to the edge, like I just did with my Thunderlord, I actually destroyed that blight really quickly. Now here, I've got a way to get around this blight. This is not the safest path, and I wouldn't recommend that, especially with that knight spawning there, but YOLO, and we got it done. What I'd recommend is making sure that you just keep moving. Again, on PC with a Warlock, I can spam my melee and my sprint and my jump at the same time, which lets me go pretty fast. You can do that on console as well, but it just looks like I'm going a little bit faster here on PC. Our second orb is in the middle, so we just got to get the third and final orb back. So again, if you find that any enemies are chasing you and maybe you just want to deal with them and get them off your back, a quick well-placed grenade like a vortex grenade or a void wall grenade would be a good idea. I am currently on my Nova Warp Warlock. Now, if you get in a situation like that, basically just keep jumping in the air and keep pushing forward, unless if there is a shielded phalanx. If there's a phalanx that's going to try and blast you off the wall, get out of their sights as quickly as possible. I'm actually going to run over here to this area because none of the enemies are spawned over here. There might be a knight that spawns in like right here, but I can easily slip right past him. Very simple, very easy. Now here you'll see I just take a quick lane right around that blight. Do be careful if you're using the melee sprint jump like I'm doing there, because sometimes it will track into different enemies that you don't want to fight. Once you get the third orb into the middle, it will create a pool of boundless light, which will recharge your abilities and your supers very quickly. Now, this is a great ascendant challenge to get done. Like if you are looking to get one of your bounties for one of the bounties that give you the mods for the Dreaming City, where you have to kill multiple knights while ascendant, this is a great and easy challenge for this. In fact, this is the easiest of all the challenges because literally you just keep getting your super back and you keep killing all of the knights. With the Hunter, I'd recommend Arc Strider, Blade Barrage. I wouldn't necessarily recommend Golden Gun. You basically just want to keep on doing large area burst damage through all the different enemies. You can see there that it does refill relatively quickly, but you want to keep moving because there are many, many Thrall that try and kill you as well. But here, I wanted to try out the new Nova Warp, the Nova Warp that's been buffed for the last couple of weeks. And I've been really enjoying it in PvP, so I thought I'd bring it in here and show you how to do the Ascendant Challenge. As always, make sure that you pick up the chest. If you complete the challenge by killing the bosses and you don't pick up the chest, the bounty won't actually complete. So make sure you do that. That will spawn the portal, and then you will be set. The first egg location is going to be over back behind the portal on one of the ledges that goes up very, very high. You're going to look off to the right-hand side. You can see that the portal is right there. It's back behind it. We're going to go ahead and look off to the right-hand side of that large platform, that large hill that goes up. We're going to shoot the first egg. The second egg is really easy. Look to the right of the portal. Look for these two columns right here. We're going to go ahead and move through this area. Go through two sets of pillars. You can see I'm looking down, looking for it. And it's possible you may have a blight in this area. You may not. Don't use that as a reference point. Use those pillars and those columns to locate that second and final egg in this Ascendant Challenge. Finally, the bones location. If you remember the portal and the large hill where we went up, what we're going to do is go up the hill about halfway, and then we're going to actually look off to the left. The hill splits off into a fork. We're going to head over to the left-hand side. We're going to go ahead and take a look. There is Toland over there hanging out, and we're going to follow this concrete path almost all the way around, very much on the outside of the map. You'll see a round circular platform here. That is your cue to start looking down below and looking for the sparkle of the Ahamkara bones. We're actually going to hop down here one more set. We're going to get, again, looking for those pillars. We're going to go ahead and get on the second platform, and we're going to look down below, and you're going to see the sparkle of the platform. You want to time your jump so that you land without breaking your ankles, like many guardians do. And once you pick that up, you will have the Ahamkara lore bones for this Ascendant Challenge, and you're all set. Quick note, you will not be able to get back up to the portal from this area except with some massive platforming, so I recommend just jumping off the edge, but don't get the Ahamkara bone until the very, very end. So guys, that is the Forfeit Shrine Ascendant Challenge. Very simple and very easy. I hope you've enjoyed the guide. Like I said earlier in the guide, this is a very chill week inside of Destiny, so maybe this is a great time for you to go into competitive. Maybe you want to go after the Legend and the Unbroken title. Maybe you want to go farm Nightfalls or anything else like that. Maybe you want to try and get your first raid in, something like that. Go ahead and follow me on twitch.tv/manodestra77 when I go live, help people out with exotic quests like Whisper of the Worm, Outbreak Prime, other things like that. Plus, maybe even try to get some more raid help. If we can get enough people on different platforms, we can do that. Let me know what you want me to cover on the YouTube channels. I'm working on some different videos, but I'd love to hear from you down in the comments. If you like something in this video, a positive rating is greatly appreciated. Hit that subscribe button for more Destiny 2 content. Good hunting, Guardians, and I'll see you next time in the universe of Destiny.